Memphis, it's estimated that there are 40 to 50,000 people between the ages of 16 to 24 who are neither in school or working. I'm going to share how the intersection between fiber networks and artificial intelligence can potentially turn that into an advantage. Imagine a city in the early 19th century, gaslit. As dusk falls, the city rests. With the advent of electricity, streets became safer. Nightlife became more vibrant. Factories could work around the clock, leading to productivity and economic prosperity. Homes became filled with appliances that created opportunity for leisure and for learning. We are right now on the cusp of a change with fiber networks and artificial intelligence that can have an impact on the scale of electricity, and importantly, with just as much magic and change that we can't even anticipate. Now, fiber networks are not just about better downloads or uploads or streaming. Instead of moving bits on copper wires that were originally there for telephones or televisions, we are now moving bits on light over glass. That is a fundamentally different paradigm. Now, I want to talk about leapfrogging. Often, in technology, whole regions or countries can skip intermediate steps. In Africa, because landline infrastructure was sparse, expensive, because banking infrastructure was often corrupt and inefficient, and of course also expensive, we saw mobile penetration accelerate there like nowhere else in the world. And the combination of those two things led to the first true mobile banking applications emerging out of Africa. Now, something closer to home, right here in Tennessee. 2010, Chattanooga launched its city-initiated fiber network. In the first 10 years, that created over $2.7 billion of economic benefit and changed the face of that city. Now, here, fiber is no longer a miracle like it would have been in 2010 or previous, but it is what is necessary. Now, I want to think about both when and where. When? We're at the advent, within the first really 18 months of launch of artificial intelligence and its involvement with us on a daily level. With the personal computer, that was about numbers. Before the spreadsheet, personal computers were for hobbyists and gamers. After the spreadsheet, they were a necessity in every home. The internet was all about communications. With AI, it's about words and language. We now all have essentially a genie with us at all times. We can ask any question. We can hold a conversation on any topic. We can create any software. But the greater miracles are the ones that we'll see coming. Importantly, with the first computers, they didn't help people do their work better like the PC. With the first computers, they replaced a generation of workers because the change was so profound that only the young who were immersed in it were able to cope with it. Where? Memphis is a unique place. The home of Soul, of Stax, of Sun, of 3-6 Mafia, and also of the 40 to 50,000 people that I referenced earlier. I've been involved with fiber networks all over the country, and I have never seen a civic energy like I have experienced in Memphis. Young and old, rich and poor, black and white, everybody sees this as an opportunity to effect change. But where will that change have impact? In Memphis, in this country, and in fact in the world, we have an education system that is too focused on credentials, like diplomas and degrees, and not focused on learning skills for today, and even more importantly, learning how to learn. With healthcare, every issue is treated like an illness that you prescribe a pill for. We need to change that to where health is a lifelong journey that we all have agency for. I have looked up and down this agenda, and I see smart, committed people who care about Memphis, a lot of them, looking at both health and education. And what I want to really reinforce is that we are now at a unique time and place. The future is here. It's just unevenly distributed. Memphis has unique challenges. You're all much more aware of them than I am. Memphis also has a unique energy. We have a time where artificial intelligence is landing, and you're about to get a network for the next century. That's a lot of clay. And now we all have to roll up our sleeves and get to work. Thank you.